Who can be appointed as a director in a company? In Companies Act of 2013, Section 164 talks about disqualifications of appointment of director. So, whoever is not mentioned in Section 164 can be appointed as a director in a company. What are the disqualifications of appointment of director of a company? Section 164 talks about the disqualifications. The first disqualification for anyone to be appointed as a director is that if a person is of unsound mind. What do you mean by unsound mind? Any person who is having mental incapacity, who does not have the rational decision making power. Now, it is not important whether a person is unsound mind according to any other directors. What we should understand is that a competent court should have passed the order saying that Mr. So-and-so or Miss So-and-so is of unsound mind. Only then the court will call that person as unsound mind, and such a person cannot be appointed as a director in a company. The second disqualification is that if any person is an undischarged insolvent. Who is an insolvent? Basically, any person who cannot meet his liabilities with the assets that he has. He cannot be appointed as a director in a company in India. Then, the third point or the third disqualification is that any person who has applied to the court to be adjudged as insolvent. That is, he is not yet an insolvent as per the court, but he has applied to the court to be called as an insolvent, and that application is still pending. That is, the court has not yet passed the order for this person to be called as an insolvent. The fourth disqualification. Any person who has been convicted of an offense, any offense. When we say offense, it is offense under law in India, not necessarily the Companies Act. So, if any person has been convicted of an offense for a minimum of 6 months, that is, when we say convicted, it is related to imprisonment. So, let us say there is one Mr. A who has been convicted of an offense for 6 months and the conviction is for imprisonment. So, he cannot be appointed as a director in a company for 5 years. For 5 years after the last date of the conviction. So, for example, if he's been convicted on 1st of January, that is for 6 months imprisonment, till the 30th of June, he will be convicted for imprisonment, and from 1st of July, we should calculate 5 years. So, if it is the year 2016, till 2021, he cannot be appointed as a director in a company. 2021 onwards, he can be appointed as a director. Same way, you can see for 1 year, 2 year or 3 years, etc. There's one more very important condition here. If a person who has been convicted for imprisonment for 7 years or more, such a person, he cannot be appointed as a director at all. The next condition for disqualification of a director is that if any court has passed an order disqualifying a person from becoming a director, this could be under any law. The next condition for disqualification of director is that if a director has not paid the calls for the shares which he has subscribed and he has not made this payment for 6 months or more. So, the last date of the calls for payment of the shares may be, let us say, 30th of January. So, from 30th of January, we should calculate 6 months, which is the 30th of July, and from then, if he is still not paid, then he cannot be appointed as a director. The next condition is that if a person has been convicted under Section 188, that means a related party transaction. So, if any director has been convicted under Section 188, he is disqualified from being appointed as a director. And the last condition is that if a director does not have a DIN, if any person who wants to be appointed as director does not have a director identification number, then he cannot be appointed as a director in India. Section 164 talks about 8 different conditions of people who cannot be appointed as director, that is the disqualifications of any person from being a director. Just now we discussed all the disqualifications. So what it means is that apart from these 8 disqualifications, anybody can be a director in a company.